So in the midst of our crisis, we look to leaders for guidance and answers, but you've probably noticed certain cities are responding, sometimes more than even at the state level. So who do we listen to? Tonight, ABC 15's Nicole Valdez going one-on-one with Arizona's Attorney General, also asking him about a key public health meeting that wasn't so public today.
Since Arizona was pulled into the fight against the coronavirus,
I've been a big believer in, government has to be transparent and open, and especially in times of crisis more than ever.
Arizona's top prosecutor has never been one to shy away from sharing his point of view.
I think the people want to know exactly what do we anticipate happening, and really, quite frankly, how bad this is or isn't.
Mark Brnovich says his job is enforcing the law set in place, and as of Tuesday, that includes a stay-at-home order straight from Governor Ducey's office.
I am deeply concerned about the executive order.
Local leaders like Phoenix Mayor Kay Gallego butting heads with the governor, hoping to make changes as she sees fit for Phoenix, like kicking some services off Ducey's essential business list.
The big maybe question is, some people are asking is, well, wait a minute, you have the executive order of the governor, the cities are maybe being more restrictive, what takes precedent? At the end of the day, the governor's gonna have to answer that question.
But among the opinions from our attorney general, he says he's especially worried about transparency or the lack thereof.
Sometimes people are so worried that people are going to panic or what's going to happen with the information that they're refusing to give it to us. And I think that's a mistake.
Wednesday, the Arizona Department of Health Services was set to lead a medical advisory committee meeting to discuss the state's plan of action. A call posted on the state's public website, including the number to call in. But when we did, the meeting abruptly ended. And someone on the other line telling us this is not a committee for the media.
At the end of the day, you have to comply with the law.
So we asked Brnovich and his office, now looking into what happened.
If you read our opinion that we recently issued, we basically say that city governments, local governments, other agencies and boards have to comply with public records laws and the open meeting laws.
In Phoenix, Nicole Valdez, ABC 15, Arizona.